challenge of having the two services on Sunday morning. But we are here and ready to celebrate not just Palm Sunday, but the entire Passion story this morning. And so I hope that Paul Joseph got everybody tuned in to their parts. And of course, the part of the congregation will be in bold for the entire group to speak. And that will be our gospel reading this morning. And this morning, the service will begin from the rear of the church with a procession following the cross. Anybody that feels inclined to join and wave their drums in the procession is welcome to do so as we celebrate the entrance of Jesus into Jerusalem. We're following divine service setting number 4 today, the service of Holy Communion. Our worship schedule this week includes Maundy Thursday. This Thursday evening at 6:30 p.m. here in church will be a service of Holy Communion. And on Good Friday, there are two options. Here at Trinity at 1 p.m., we'll have the normal service of Good Friday. And if you miss that, at 7 p.m. in Walcottsville at St. Michael's, there is the Tenebrae service of Good Friday, which is in darkness and pretty impressive, the extinguishing of candles and that loud noise at the end that symbolizes the sealing of Jesus' tomb. So that is what lies in store. Today, we have prayers requested for the families of the school shooting shooting victims in Nashville, Tennessee. And also, Lori and I are about to become grandparents again as our daughter, Carolyn, will have her baby tomorrow because it's a scheduled cesarean section. So very early tomorrow, they go into the hospital, and at this time tomorrow, we should be grandparents of a new grandchild. So we ask your prayers for that. Congregation, please stand and face the rear of the church. The choir will sing the Hosanna processional, and then our service will begin from the rear of the church. Thank you. Since we are gathered to hear God's word, call upon him in prayer and praise, and receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in the fellowship of this altar, let us first consider our unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God, our Heavenly Father, seeking his grace for the sake of Christ, and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner.
Almighty God, have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all of your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Isiah chapter 50. The Lord God has given me the tongue of those who are taught, that I may know how to sustain with a word him who is weary. Morning by morning he awakens. He awakens my ear to hear as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I turned not backward. I gave my back to those who strike, and my cheeks to those who pull out the beard. I hid not my face from disgrace and spitting. But the Lord God helps me. Therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who is my adversary? Let him come near to me. Behold, the Lord God helps me. Who will declare me guilty? This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please sing responsibly with the cantor, Psalm 118, printed in the bulletin.
Thank you.
The epistle reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians, the second chapter. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Congregation, please stand as we speak the verse of the day responsibly. He humbled himself. I'm sorry, the choir is going to sing? The choir will sing the verse of the day. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying,
drink of it, all of you. For this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will not drink again of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom.
And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them,
You will all fall away because of me this night. For it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee.
Peter answered him,
Though they all fall away because of you, I will never fall away.
Jesus said to him,
Truly I tell you this very night, before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times.
Peter said to him,
Even if I must die with you, I will not deny you.
And all the disciples said the same.
Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
Sit here while I go over there and pray.
And taking with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them,
My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch with me.
And going a little farther, he fell on his face and prayed, saying,
My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will.
And he came to the disciples, and he found them sleeping, and he said to Peter,
So, could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Again, for the second time, he went away and prayed.
My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done.
And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words again. Then he came to the disciples and said to them,
Sleep and take your rest later on. See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
While he was still speaking, Judas came, one of the 12, and with him a great crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying,
The one I will kiss is the man. Seize him!
And he came up to Jesus at once and said,
Greetings, Rabbi.
And he kissed him. Jesus said to him,
Friend, do what you came to do.
Then they came up and laid hands on Jesus and seized him. And behold, one of those who were with Jesus stretched out his hand and drew his sword and struck the servant of the high priest and cut off his ear. Then Jesus said to him,
Put your sword back into its place, for all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do what you think that I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will at once send me more than 12 legions of angels. But how then should the scriptures be fulfilled? Then it must be so.
At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds,
Have you come out as against a robber, with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But all this has taken place that the scriptures of the prophet might be fulfilled.
Then all the disciples left him and fled. Then those who had seized Jesus led him to Caiaphas the high priest, where the scribes and the elders had gathered. Peter was following him at a distance, as far as the courtyard of the high priest. And going inside, he sat with the guards to see the end. Now the chief priests and the whole council were seeking false testimony against Jesus, that they might put him to death. But they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. At last, two came forward and said,
This man said, I am able to destroy the temple of God and build it in 3 days.
And the high priest stood up and said,
Have you no answer to me? What is it that these men testify against you?
But Jesus remained silent, and the high priest said to him,
I adjure you by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God.
Jesus said to him,
You have said so. But I tell you, from now on you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven.
Then the high priest tore his robes and said,
He has uttered blasphemy. What further witness?
struck him, and some slapped him, saying,
Prophesy to us, you Christ. Who is it that struck you?
Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard, and a servant girl came up to him and said,
You also were with Jesus of Galilee.
But he denied it before them all, saying,
I do not know what you mean.
And when he went out to the entrance, another servant girl saw him, and she said to the bystanders,
This man was with Jesus of Nazareth.
And again he denied it with an oath.
I do not know the man.
After a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter,
Certainly you too are one of them, for your accent betrays you.
And would invoke a curse upon himself and to swear,
I do not know the man.
And immediately the rooster crowed, and Peter remembered the saying of Jesus,
Before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times.
And he went out and wept bitterly.
When morning came, all the chief priests and the elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. And they bound him and led him away and delivered him over to Pilate, the governor. Then when Judas, his betrayer, saw that Jesus was condemned, he changed his mind and brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and the elders, saying,
I have sinned by betraying innocent blood.
What is that to us? See to it yourself.
And throwing down the pieces of silver into the temple, he departed, and he went and hanged himself. But the chief priests, taking the pieces of silver, said,
It is not lawful to put them into the treasury, since it is blood money.
So they took counsel, and bought with them the potter's field as a burial place for strangers. Therefore that field has been called the field of blood to this day. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken by the prophet Jeremiah, saying, And they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him on whom a price had been set by some of the sons of Israel, and they gave them for the potter's field, as the Lord directed me. Now Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him,
Are you the king of the Jews?
Jesus said,
You have said so.
But when he was accused by the chief priests and elders, he gave no answer. Then Pilate said to him,
Do you not hear how many things they testify against you?
But he gave him no answer, not even to a single charge, so that the governor was greatly amazed. Now at the feast, the governor was accustomed to release for the crowd any one prisoner whom they wanted. And they had then a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when they had gathered, Pilate said to them,
Whom do you want me to release for you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called Christ?
For he knew that it was out of envy that they had delivered him up. Besides, while he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him,
Have nothing to do with that righteous man, for I have suffered much because of him today and you.
Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowd to ask for Barabbas and destroy Jesus. The governor again said to them,
Which of the two do you want me to release for you?
And they said,
Barabbas.
Pilate said to them,
Then what shall I do with Jesus, who is called Christ?
They all said,
Let him be crucified.
And he said,
Why, what evil has he done?
But they shouted all the more,
Let him be crucified.
So when Pilate saw that he was gaining nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning, he took water and washed his hands before the crowd, saying,
I am innocent of this man's blood. See to it yourselves.
And all the people answered,
His blood be on us and on our children.
Then he released for them Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the governor's headquarters, and they gathered the whole battalion before him. And they stripped him, and put a scarlet robe on him, and twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on his head, and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying,
Hail, King of the Jews!
And they spit on him, and took the reed, and struck him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the robe and put his own clothes on him and led him away to crucify him. As they went out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. They compelled this man to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means place of a skull, they offered him wine to drink mixed with gall, but when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his garments among them by casting lots. Then they sat down and kept watch over him there. And over his head they put the charge against him, which read,
"This is Jesus, the King of Jews."
Then two robbers were crucified with him, one on the right and one on the left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying,
"You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross."
So also the chief priests with the scribes and the elders mocked him, saying,
"He saved others, he cannot save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down now from the cross, and we will believe in him. He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now, if he desires him. For he said, I am the Son of God."
And the robbers who were crucified with him also reviled him in the same way. From the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, saying,
"Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? My God, why have you forsaken me?"
And some of the bystanders hearing it said,
"This man is calling Elijah."
And one of them at once ran and took a sponge, filled it with sour wine, and put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink. But the others said,
"Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him."
And Jesus cried out again with a loud voice and yielded up his spirit. And behold, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. And the earth shook, and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. And coming out of the tombs after his resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many. When the centurion and those who were with him, keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what took place, they were filled with awe, and they said,
"Surely this was the Son of God."
There were also many women there, looking on from a distance, who had followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering to him, among whom were Mary Magdalene, and Mary, the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of the sons of Zebedee. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who also was a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate ordered it to be given to him, and Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen shroud and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had cut in the rock. And he rolled a great stone to the entrance of the tomb and went away. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were there, sitting opposite the tomb. The next day, that is, after the day of preparation, the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered before Pilate and said,
"Sir, we remember how the impostor said while he was still alive, 'After 3 days I will rise.' Therefore, order the tomb to be made secure until the third day, lest his disciples go and steal him away and tell the people he is risen from the dead, and the last fraud will be worse than the first."
Pilate said to them,
"You have our soldiers go, make it as secure as you can."
So they went and made the tomb secure by sealing the stone and setting a guard. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Congregation, please stand as we confess our faith, speaking the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and of all things visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God,
begotten of his Father before all worlds,
God of God, light of light,
very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made,
who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven,
and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary,
and was made man,
and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate,
and suffered and was buried,
and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures,
and ascended into heaven,
and sits at the right hand of God.
And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead,
whose kingdom will have no end.
And I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord and giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified,
who spoke by the prophets.
And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church.
I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins,
and I look for the resurrection of the dead
and the life
of the world to come. Amen.
Congregation, please be seated as we sing hymn 543, What Wondrous Love Is This?